Are you like me, an audio post professional who has to maximize their time? Whether it's working from home sometimes or when you're on the road and you want to work on that 5.1 film but don't have access to your normal studio. Or alternatively, maybe you don't have a 5.1 space or a surround space you can mix in, but you hire one out. Maybe you want to do a pre-dub where you set up your pans, make sure your reverbs are correct before you go into the soundstage. Well, I've got a solution for you. Waves recently released the NX Virtual Studio Collection, which is a collection of plugins that have virtual studios in them. So you can mix in some world-class studios through their monitors and hear it in their space. Waves also sent me an NX head tracker, which is an attachment you put on your headphones that tracks your head so that you can feel that virtual space. Think of it as the Atmos feature on your Apple AirPods. If you don't want to spend the money on the NX head tracker, no worries. You can use your webcam or your front-facing camera on your laptop to track your head as you move around, and you'll get the same effect. You can also use both to get even better accuracy when you move your head. The two setups we can use is the original NX plugin, or they've just released Germano Studio in New York, which has a 5.1 setup. So that means you can sit in that space wherever you are, and you get to test out your mixes. I've only recently received the gear, so I've actually not had much time to test it, but I've opened up an old project just with some stems in 5.1 so I can show you what the capabilities are of this plugin. So as you can see, I've got my headphones on with my head tracker here, and we have the Germano Studio set up. Let's dive into this software and how it works. I just wanted to show you what it's capable of doing and how you can use it in a pre-dubbing 5.1 setup here. So I will play you some dialogue here and you will see the head tracking movement as well. So I'm going to start off by just moving my head. So here we go.
Several years ago, I guess. Or seven.
So we click this calibrate button with our face facing forward.
Oh, she preferred someone more.
Interesting.
Now I'm going to move the dialogue all the way around me.
Several years ago, I guess.
So this is panning in surround sound.
I hear that's a long time in human terms. How did it go?
You get a better sense of it when you're actually turning your head as well. You get a sense of where the ambiences are.
I just haven't met the right one yet. God knows how many women there are in the world.
So we can turn our head to that back speaker. That's there. 49.6%
of the world's population. I'm sure one of them will like you.
Another way to really show it off is we'll go to the score. So let me find a part of the score. And with this score, I mix the surrounds quite loud to give you that, because it's mostly dialogue, there's not a lot of action going on or anything like that. I use the music as a way to really bring out the surrounds. So you can hear that I've mixed the certain synths behind us, as well as you've got the main kick and that punching in the front. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to just bypass it. So this is a stereo down mix of the surround sound mix. So if I turn my head, that kick and synth is still, you know, following me around, right? Let me turn it back on. Here we go. So you can obviously hear the room as well, which is great. Like it's nice to just hear that little bit of space because, you know, if you were sitting at home in a home theater, that's what it would sound like. You know, you would hear your own room there as well. So I'll show you what you can do when you push the ambience a bit. So we could have it dry. So here's the dialogue in the room.
3.7 billion, totaling an average 49.6% of the world's population.
So that's it dry.
One of them will like you.
Oh, but that's it. It could be any of them.
And there we go, pushing the room.
It's entirely based on chance and luck.
Then make your own luck.
What?
I know this is just a basic rundown, but I really just wanted you to get a sense of what it could be like working in this. So you know, when you turn your head, if you listen to music and you want to mix the surrounds, either the music or the reverbs, use this to really mix, get a sense of how much you want to mix in, just as a good starting point before you go and hit the dub stage. Especially for, say, sound effects and things, you can really get your pans in a good place. Obviously, you know, you want to fine tune that later on. I'll just show you some of the sound effects. There's not a lot in this film, but I'll just play you some random parts of the film. So I'll play that again, but we're going to bypass it. So it's still, you know, sounds nice, sounds immersive, and it gives you, you know, you could mix, you could probably do some pre-dubs and guess beforehand, but I really do think you get that immersive sense, just that the almost the plane, the dimension this way as well. I'll play it again for you. I know it's a bit tricky because I'm moving my head, and if you're not, it's sort of hard to gauge, but I would definitely recommend you downloading a demo of this and giving it a try and just using your camera. And if you really feel like, you know, it's working for you, maybe you'd get the head tracker as well to really, like, between the two of them, you'll get a more accurate reading. So as you can hear, as I turn my head, you can hear I've put some of the general cafe ambience. I've got some behind and in front, and you can tell that when you turn your head. You know, it's a bit subtle at the back, heavier at the front, just so it doesn't distract. Some foley in there. Let's just have a listen to the whole thing for a minute.
I'm not a mega block, Jim. I have constant 360-degree vision. The universe is presenting you with this opportunity. What if she's your match? The one you've been waiting for your whole life?
But I can't just walk up to her. I need something to build off, to establish a rapport.
I'll bypass it again.
I'll cut you off then.
What? No, what are you gonna...
Bless you.
So it's bypass.
I opened that right up for you.
Back on.
Right. Now she thinks I sneeze like an elephant.
Come on, Jim. Look at her. She's much too sophisticated for that.
One thing I'd recommend doing, though, is when you are working on this, to check your reverbs and things as well, is to just turn it off or even just turn the ambience down as well. So you'll still get that sensation of the virtual room and the panning, but just so you make sure the reverbs you are putting into your dialogue or sound effects, you know, you're not getting distracted by the ambience of the virtual room. You know what is your reverb and what is that's the virtual space. I know I haven't gone in depth into the plugin and its feature set and how to use it, how to set it up, but there are other videos by Waves that will do that, as well as show you what the other studios sound like. But I wanted to focus mostly on the 5.1 feature of this, so that you as audio post mixers who are mixing in surround sound have a way of working without having your studio there. Currently, NX Virtual Studio Collection is on sale for $79.99 US, down from $699. So that's a huge saving. So I recommend get a demo, check it out. Just use your webcam as a head tracker, but I would recommend collecting the head tracker as well and using them in combination. To support this channel, please use the links in the description below if you're gonna make any purchases. Obviously I get a kickback, but it does help the channel. It helps me keep making these tutorials for you all. So also hit the like button, subscribe if you haven't already, and also send me some comments if you got any questions. I'd be happy to answer them. Thanks again for joining me, and we'll talk to you soon.